Hello, everyone, and a very warm welcome to the Singapore Tourism Board Marketing College Masterclass Series 2022. Today's theme will center on inspire travel and capture growth. And now, more than ever before, I'm sure all of us realize that marketing capabilities are fundamental to enable travel and tourism businesses to capture growth and inspire travel to Singapore. Today, we are very pleased to have the experts at TikTok here with us to outline the ways to drive travel inspiration and discovery for your travel audience on their platform, as well as outline three key pillars of travel content creation and ways to drive conversion. And more importantly, they're also going to be here to tell us how to engage users' different interests and take advantage of festive occasions. Joining us today, we have Terence Ong, who is the regional brand strategist for the travel vertical at TikTok. His experience includes working with brands from different industries and across various aspects such as creative, media, and campaign execution. We also have with us today Aisha Mirza, who is the client solutions lead within the regional brand team at TikTok, focusing on the government, tourism, finance, and entertainment vehicles. Aisha's experience covers stints in TV, creative agencies, and social media before finding her home at TikTok. I'm sure this will be an interesting session for us all. Over to you, Aisha.
Thank you, Delisha. And good morning, everyone. Welcome to this masterclass with us. We're very excited to have you on this voyage. So let me take you through what we'll be going through this presentation today. So here's the structure of today's session. We'll start with a quick introduction of why travel is ever so pertinent now, followed by some insights we have on how travelers consume content. Then we will spend some time talking through how to make the content work for you and show you some examples of how you can partner with TikTok to do this. And finally, we have a Q&A section at the end, and we will be answering some of the questions that you have sent through. All right then, so buckle up, we're about to go on a journey. I'm sure all of us here are well aware that countries around the world are opening up. And with the easing of restrictions comes the possibility of easier, less risky travel. And Singapore is well aware of this, of course, and we're ready to open up our borders to all the travelers who have had to remain grounded over the past 2 years. So what does travel in 2022 look like? We have distilled this into four key points from a variety of reports. Number one, people are likely to spend more on travel because they want to maximize the experience and make up for lost time. Budgets are likely to be secondary while enjoyment comes first. Number two, both domestic and international travel will see a rebound. With the easing of restrictions, it's important for travelers to be able to make trips without having to self-isolate. The third, as expected, health and safety are key. This doesn't just refer to personal safety, but also making sure that there are adequate measures and protocols in place, even with COVID-19 cases dropping worldwide. And finally, workcations are also on the rise. Now that we've all experienced remote working and it has been proven to work for most industries, the flexibility it offers means that travel is not necessarily the escape from work it once was. It can now be quite compatible thanks to remote work policies. So now we have an idea of what we're working with. Let's switch tracks and get a deeper understanding of how travelers consume content with Terence.
Cool, thanks Aisha. So good morning guys, happy to be here with you to share how travel is like on TikTok. So you know, to get everyone excited, let's watch a quick video.
Thank you.
Oh, so not sure about you, but I got strong wanderlust vibes in that video. So what is TikTok? TikTok is entertainment that connects. Firstly, it's cinematic. So by having a full screen and a sound on platform. Secondly, its short video format allows people to enjoy bite-sized, binge-worthy content. Lastly, the users on the app helps to form a vibrant community based on their passions. Also, from a commission study, 74% of users use TikTok to be entertained. So TikTok's For You page actually helps to drive inspiration and discovery. Through the algorithm, users might be recommended videos that has been well received by other users with similar interests. However, videos in For You are deliberately varied, so users will avoid seeing the same content or themes. Therefore, there is more opportunities to discover new content categories and also new creators. So it is also where people look for inspiration for their trips and weekend plans. For the first video, we see Singaporean singer Ben King doing a funny dance with his wife in the places that they have traveled. The second video is about nature and more specifically what you can do at Changi Bay Point. Let's play the video.
Four things to do at Changi Bay Point. The newest PC NNS deal. One cyclist can rent two skateboarding, three walk, and take pic for chill and picnic.
Yeah, that's probably what I'm going to do this long weekend. So the third video is about a user posting her experience at Sky Helix in Sentosa and rating her experience there. Let's watch this video.
Things you need to know about Sky Helix Sentosa.
So lastly, for the fourth video, we have users sharing staycation ideas such as this hotel with Bali vibes. So here's a snapshot of TikTok scale globally, right? So officially, we have 1 billion monthly active users in just 5 short years. So this is significantly quicker than most of our competitors. In addition, based on a Kantar report, we are also ranked first in terms of ad equity for 2 years in a row. And this is beating out the likes of Instagram, Google, and Twitter. So here we take a look at how travelers plan their journey. So they fall into four categories, namely inspiration, shopping, booking, sharing at adventuring and sharing. So for the inspiration stage, you know, they look at travel ideas, research on destinations, and etc. For shopping, they begin to shortlist flights, dates, activities, and also compare reviews. For the booking stage, they actually make the actual reservations. And for adventuring and sharing, they go on the trip itself, experience it, and share reviews during or after the trip. So other than travel, APAC travel lovers also have a wide range of interests, just like you and me. So some of them includes music, food and drinks, films and cinema, and so on. And what is the reason why people travel? They want to explore and discover. So from here, we see that 60% of them likes to travel the world. 53% both like to know what is going on in the world. and they are also interested in other cultures. 47% also want to be the first to try new things. So you may ask, what is TikTok's role in all of this? Well, TikTok is the place where people take a trip before deciding if the trip is worth taking. It is the trip before the trip, where people come to TikTok to do travel research before booking. During the strict travel restrictions for COVID, you can see people sharing tips and experiences on COVID-related travel costs, their experiences, guidelines, and also hacks. We had quite a lot of video views for the various hashtags like vaccine passport, COVID travel, DTL as well. Our users also like to share their experiences with others, with these hashtags getting millions of views, like travel diaries with 311 million views, travel vlog with 276 million views, and travel with me at 100 million views. So these numbers are growing as we speak. There is also a diverse group of travelers, right? So they go on various holidays, such as relaxing ones. They explore cityscapes. They join activities like shark cage diving, exploring nature, enjoying budget or luxury holidays, getting on cruises and more. There are also many passionate communities gathered towards these hashtags, like bucket list travel, ecotourism, travel photography, travel vlog with millions of views each. So you may ask, what about conversions? And majority of our users also mentioned that TikTok plays a role in influencing bookings. 69% agrees that travel content on TikTok helps to encourage purchase of a product or activity. And about 68% also agree that TikTok helps to decide on which product or activity to choose. 38% of users also shared that they have purchased a travel product after seeing it on TikTok. And what we know is that TikTok users in APAC, they love traveling and they love sharing about their trips. 1 in 2 are interested in travel, and they are 50% more likely to post about travel online versus a non-TikTok user. Here's a quick snippet on some internal data. Travel content consumption across Southeast Asia is growing, and it has grown 2.8 times year on year. Next, we also take a quick look at the top hashtags in Southeast Asia. Other than destinations, users often use hashtags like travel, vacation ideas like hashtag nature, hashtag beach, and hashtags related to travel hacks and tips as well. From a commission study, 96% of TikTok users feel that travel is important to them. And here's a quote from Brian Povinelli, the SVP of Brand Loyalty and Portfolio Marketing at Marriott. When we step out into the world, we are forever transformed by the places, cultures, and people we encounter. And he also mentioned that TikTok is a compelling platform for people to not only share about how they feel about travel, can help transform them, but also get people back out on the road and following that wanderlust. So for the next part of our journey, Aisha will take you through on how to make content work for you. Over to you, Aisha.
Thank you, Terence. So we've established what to expect with travel in 2022 and the types of content that travelers consume. So now let's dive into how you can make this content work for you. We've broken up travel content into 3 pillars: inspiration, information, and entertainment. And you'll notice that all 3 are not just in line with our platform, they also offer value to users in different ways. If we were to break it down further, inspiration helps to drive FOMO and wanderlust, right? FOMO meaning fear of missing out. It gives people the nudge they need to want to take a trip somewhere and consider the possibilities of all the places and experiences out there. Information adds value and enhances experiences in the sense that it is actionable, or it uncovers things like insider tips and tricks, or provides clarity on how to make the most of a trip. Entertainment is the main means of engagement. It's usually what sells an experience in a way that is authentic and enjoyable through things like storytelling. So these pillars will then work across a range of interests and passions. They fit in with the various tribes, if you will, your foodies, your explorers, your culture vultures, shopaholics, adventurers, for example, and the list can go on and on. So let's take a look at how this could work across the interests we've identified. For foodies, inspiration is likely always going to be various restaurants they can try, along with some beauty shots of the ambiance or the food. When it comes to entertainment, we can always do something a bit more personal, like this guy right here.
Oh my God, so I went to this place called Ham Bao Bao, right? Or Ham Bao Bao, I don't know how to pronounce lah, but anyways. The burgers are damn good, eh? Okay, this is the menu, you can pause and see lah. They got dessert also. See, not cream pie. Anyways, it was $8.50. I don't know why they write it as Su York, I don't know what is that, but I bought the crispy pork belly. And the burgers were so big, and the quality is actually damn good. Okay, test. I cannot eat a burger with one hand, so I just eat one pork. I tell you, when you mean it's crispy, it's really crispy. You should buy it.
So I can't even eat that burger, but I feel the passion and it encourages you, right? It's uplifting in a sense that it makes you want to go and find out more because it's so personal. Similarly, when it comes to people interested in shopping, for example, the informative route will often have many details included. So something like this. So pretty straightforward, right? Entertainment can also take a slightly different approach, right? So something almost documentary style or a persona based. So let me play some of this for you as well.
My name is Alex. My shop selling mostly t-shirt, band t-shirt at Peninsula Shopping Center, basement B133. Welcome to my shop.
For the culture shapers, inspiration comes in the form of a variety of work and mediums, something you might not have expected to see in this little red dot. And information takes a similar approach as some of the others, but it can be a bit more stylized, like so. And for action seekers, you know, they are naturally drawn to, you guessed it, action shots, right? Inspiration will come in the form of something unconventional or thrilling, like bungee jumping, for example. So if you look at the GIF that we have here, it has a very serene quality to it, but the guy is doing something completely adventurous. And that is kind of the vibe that, you know, these videos would tend to go for. As for inspiration, it has the signature details, right? But it still holds the stylistic choices that will appeal to this interest group in particular.
Don't miss out on One for One Luge every Monday.
And of course, interests are not the only way to leverage on content. The use of hashtags that are relevant to your content and getting experimental with trendy music you can discover through our Creative Center, other ways that you know you can get through, you know, to the audience. So here we have the ever so famous TikTok Make Me Buy It hashtag with this travel necessities, like this multifunction luggage that after watching this video, I now really want. It can be locations like Siloso Beach, where we were seeing the glow-in-the-dark shores for a while, which would have also appealed to nature enthusiasts as well. We have the iconic Madame Tussauds, which, you know, is globally renowned. And STB actually created a really good piece of content using a trending sound as part of an organic challenge earlier this year. Users were supposed to select 27 videos and let it automatically sync to the track. So let's take a look at what this looked like. Feels, am I right? And of course, you know, given our multicultural makeup, we cannot look past festive occasions and the timely opportunities that they offer us as well. Starting with the most timely one for right now, Ramadan leading up to Hari Raya. So inspiration can come in the form of the incredible range of delicious food available at the bazaars, and information could be more educational with bite-sized information, such as this video.
Here are 5 facts about Ramadan that you should know. Ramadan is the 9th month of the Islamic calendar and the Muslims will fast for 30 days. Now, this is the interesting part. The Islamic calendar is based on lunar cycles, so the exact dates for Ramadan change every year. Muslims are expected to fast throughout Ramadan, abstaining not only from food, but also drinks and other pleasures from dawn to dusk. No, don't mistaken it as intermittent fasting. They are not even allowed to drink water. It emphasizes on the importance of self-control and a reminder of the suffering of the poor. There are some people who are exempted from fasting, and they include pregnant women, mothers who are breastfeeding, and those who are feeling unwell. Individuals who are traveling, engaged in hard labor, or women having their menses can skip some days and make up for them later. Children are not obligated to fast until they reach puberty. Individuals are encouraged to discontinue their Ramadan fast if it threatens their overall health.
Yeah, so, you know, these nuggets of information are what people who are interested in culture would really, you know, be drawn to. And of course, entertainment can come in many forms. Like in the case of these sisters picking out their favorite outfits or baju raya at a boutique. Similarly for Chinese New Year, inspiration could look like options available for festive treats created by this Bakwa family, for example.
Meet the core family that bonds over bakwa all year round.
Aside
from the usual bakwa flavors, the Ko family have also introduced different flavors like cinnamon, oregano, and even cheese.
Our family bond lah through tasting and eating. Of course. Yeah.
So many families bond over food, but
information can of course be greetings in Mandarin or various dialects even. And entertainment can be something that's a bit more stylized and aesthetic. So this video reminds me of one of those home makeover shows, only this is a more festive transformation. So let me show you this. And of course, Christmas with its universal appeal, right? Inspiration could be different takes on Christmas trees, such as this one.
Yesterday, I went to Charlotte Puxley Flowers, one of my favorite florists in Singapore, to attend the workshop of the pickle tree just in time for Christmas. We watched the arrangement and then created our own and took home the most beautiful vase. I absolutely love Charlotte Puxley. She is known to keep everything wild, and that's just what I like in arrangements. So here is mine. I hope that you attend the workshop with your BFF or other half because it was so much fun. Enjoy.
For the foodies, of course, the seasonal promotions and goodies that are available are of interest, such as this one.
Christmas is near. Festive cakes are here. These Kopi brownies from Toastbox look so cute, right? Christmas tree, reindeer, snowman. It's not too sweet with a hint of coffee aroma. This winter cherry butter cake comes with a snowy peak of coconut shavings. With cherries hidden in the snow. Nice, right? Recommend score? 8.5. Don't say bocho.
And it's also very personable, right? Like, users feel like they're getting a recommendation from a friend. And of course, you know, a unique experience for the action seekers, who let us come along with them as they cycle through a Christmassy Singapore. All right, so what does it all look like when it comes together then? TikTok has a range of solutions available that we can mix and match to help reach your specific objectives. So let me take you through what some of these are and then our favorite examples from the travel space. Here's an overview of our full funnel advertising solutions addressing specific goals and objectives. So each ad solution corresponds with a specific marketing objective. Top views are the first ads people see when they open our app. It's full screen, sound on, and extremely high impact. In-feed ads are another format and they cover a whole range of objectives. It can also include reach and frequency, as well as auction solutions. Each campaign can be set up with a set objective, and these ads will be optimized to meet the set objective that you have previously selected. They are super flexible and allow for trackers to be appended, interactive add-ons like gift code cards, and can even be used for everything from reach or lead generation to even driving purchases or app installs. Our content ad solutions, however, are probably what people think of most when they think of TikTok. Branded hashtag challenges and branded effects are great for awareness and consideration because they help to create movements among our audience. Effects, of course, are a visual element to help enhance how messages are delivered to users. These are very much upper funnel solutions and can help users build affinity and understanding of their brand, their offerings, or a specific message. And of course, creator marketing underpins everything that we do on the platform. It's definitely something that will help boost visibility, authenticity of your content among our users. So on to some case studies. So the first one is by the UAE, the world's coolest winter campaign. This campaign succeeded in introducing UAE's beautiful nature, culture, heritage, history, architecture, landmarks, all of the above, right, to local and international audiences, and to highlight the tourism experience in each of the seven Emirates. The hashtag challenge featured multiple creators and amplifications were kept as native as possible. custom sounds meant that there was an auditory link to the brand as well, which would have helped drive the eventual impact we saw. And in this case, it was a 25% uplift in awareness, 17% uplift in intent, 89% likes on the ad, and over 8.7K UGCs. Next, we can look at lastminute.com, right? Their priority was garnering as much awareness as possible. Hence, with the use of our most premium high-impact format, the top view, it helped ensure that every user in the country would have had the chance to see this ad. They followed up with a sustenance content through in-feed ads to drive the message home. And this campaign saw an incredible 18% engagement rate and about 51K likes. So while this was an upper funnel campaign, if they wanted to, they could have also done something like retargeting users to their site and gradually get them to book a holiday with them as we move them through the funnel. Sun Express ran a more straightforward campaign using in-feed ads for mass awareness, and they chose to do something a bit more narrative-led. So let me show you this video. It's a fun, joyful piece of work. And while it reached a lot of people, it also managed to drive interest about the airline as well through the 120K clicks observed. So what's great about this is if Sun Express had a pixel installed, for example, it would have been able to be the perfect base to start running conversion campaigns for the users who had already expressed interest in the brand. So as you might have noticed, many of these case studies start at the top funnel to cast a wide net to reach as many users as possible. And then the next steps to move audiences down the funnel are clear and easily actionable. And of course, right, to promote an experience, the best way to do it is to show what people are in for. And that's exactly what Park Asterix did with their campaign with the aim of raising awareness and engagement. They ran in-feed ads using content from creators to deliver an honest, authentic message, and it not just reached over 2 million people, it also drove over 1K followers, an indication that users really liked what they saw. For key events like this, a part two of the campaign could have included something like a brand new lead gen ad to drive signups once people are hyped up for, you know, this event, for example. As we come to the end of this little trip we took together, I would love for you all to remember these four key takeaways when thinking about what's next. First, travel will see a strong comeback, evidenced by people's sentiments and increasing travel content consumptions. It's been 2 years of being grounded. People are ready to fly. Second, TikTok plays an important role in each step of the traveler's consumer journey. But this, of course, can be customized to your goals. Be laser focused on your objectives and how to achieve them. Third, the travel audience has a strong presence on TikTok, and it's the right moment for brand to hop on board the flight. The communities we have around travel and experiences are strong, and word of mouth is extremely effective. So think hashtags like TikTok made me buy it, as seen on TikTok, that sort of thing. And lastly, engage consumers at their passion point and during special occasions. Meet them where they are to minimize the number of steps they need to find resonance and relatability in your content. And that is all from me. We can then move on to the Q&A section.
Welcome back, everyone. Lots of thrills, lots of feels, and lots of spills leading us to great content that can drive conversion on TikTok. Thank you, team. I would like to welcome Dana Ho to the Q&A panel. Dana is the Brand Partnerships Vertical Lead for TikTok, and she began her career working on brands with global or regional portfolios in markets like Hong Kong, Thailand, China, and of course, here in Singapore. So we're looking forward to Dana sharing her wealth of experience in the advertising and marketing realm as well. So Dana, since you're new to the panel and have joined us for this session, the first question is for you. How should brands consider partnerships with content creators on TikTok? And how effective has this been for brands?
Hi, everyone. Good morning. I'm really sorry. I'm kind of almost losing my voice right now, but I hope I'll be able to answer this question well. So that's a really, really interesting question because really here at TikTok, our mission is really to inspire creativity and bring joy. And more often than not, TikTok creators tend to know how to do this best. I mean, some of the reasons why brands should really consider building partnerships with TikTok creators is really that their content tends to lead to better results. In a recent study that we did recently, it shows that content creators' content tends to led to a 5x completion rate and had double the conversion rate. So that's pretty high and good, and you would see the kind of results that it brings. Next, also here at TikTok, you know, whether our creators have 1,000 followers or 1 million, they really can help supercharge your paid performance by 2x when it comes to a 6 seconds view through rate and engagement rate. Some numbers that you would really, really like to try out because it's really proven some results here. Thank you.
I beg your pardon, I'm on mute. Sounds good, Dana. Lots going on. And I do think conversion rates look really positive. There's a lot to think about when venturing onto a platform like TikTok, especially for the first time. What are your recommendations on pro tips or growth hacks, if you will, for a brand on TikTok?
Yes, I mean, that really, really depends on your brand or your company objectives with TikTok. But let me give you a little bit of an overall view on how we think the 8 top line guidelines on how one can approach TikTok. The first is really to create a business account and get your account verified. If you are users in TikTok, which I hope everyone are users here at TikTok, if you open your profile page, you could see a blue tick button beside it. That's what we mean by getting your account verified. Second, it's really, really important to be organic, which includes being native and authentic. As we say, our platform really believes in being native and authentic. This really helps to augment success or good content that will be viewed by many by being both organic as well with paid. Third, finding your own TikTok lens. Here at TikTok, we like to tell everyone that you are a creator. Anyone can be a creator, right? So find what's the right TikTok lens for you, for your brand. It can be anything. Fourth, create a content calendar. Like how we would approach it with any other social media. look into key dates and key milestones maybe, and create a content calendar that really helps you to guide you through the months or the years to come. Fifth, look into the different types of trends on TikTok and tap into it where applicable. I know it's very difficult for everyone says, how do I find the trends? How do I look for it? We do have some tools available, but most importantly, the best way to find trends on TikTok is to use TikTok. Six, make your talks tick. And here are a few ways that you can do it. Besides making your content native, have a really clear message because we are about a short form video. Last but not least, be very selective of your sound and music you use because that's really important in TikTok. We're all about sound on. Seven, manage your account by establishing your custodians, by managing your community and amplifying your best content. Last but not least, the eighth rule is create with TikTok creators because who knows our platform best are the people who use it day in and day out. Thank you.
Thank you, Dana. It's very clear that authenticity is really at the core of, you know, a successful story on TikTok. No surprises there. Thank you. So Ayesha, what are the analytics available for brands who, you know, got on, are really authentic, and then now they want to measure their success through reach or engagement, be it paid or organic on the TikTok platform?
My most asked question. So all the usual metrics are available, your impressions, video views, click-through rates, watch percentiles, etc. The full list of metrics and their definitions are available on the TikTok Business Help Center, which is a resource that is free for everyone to access. So I want to talk a little bit about what campaign success means, right? So campaign success is absolutely also defined by the objectives they are meant to reach. So the products that we use in corresponding to these objectives are how we will then achieve campaign success. So for reach campaigns, that would normally be what we would normally look at are things like impressions, CPM, unique reach, and for engagement or community interaction, campaigns as we call them, these can be assessed based on paid profile visits or paid followers. Personally, I also like to use watch times as an indicator of whether something was able to hold user attention and communicate key messages as well. But I would just say that, you know, when looking at analytics, just be very mindful of how the campaign is being optimized and then judge accordingly from there.
Okay, you know, and again, dashboards are available and really, you know, it's quite easy to kind of self-serve to really look at what is driving your quote-unquote success on the TikTok platform. Great, thank you. We do know that a lot of the tourism businesses who join us for Marketing College may be small and medium enterprises. So how would small and medium businesses on a budget drive conversion through TikTok? How can we use TikTok effectively to market our events or our special promotions?
Great question. So conversion campaigns, in this case, we're going to be talking mostly about web or app. And we also have things like e-commerce solutions like collection ads, catalog sales that can be used to support things like purchases. For event signups, you will be looking at something like lead generation. So my main consideration with these is to ensure that you have enough lead time to allow for system learning, because as per all, you know, conversion campaigns, the system needs a bit of time. And to not spread the budget a bit too thinly across the campaign period. Cool. Having ample creatives is another thing that you would want to have because our learning phase ends after 50 conversions. So the question about like, is the budget going to be enough? We can definitely always start small. And we have tools available on the dashboards that will allow you to kind of mix and match and like, optimize creatives quite simply from the dashboard. And, you know, once you're ready to come on board and do, you know, conversion campaigns with TikTok, the team is definitely here to help walk you through it, given, you know, any considerations you might already have. And then we can work out a solution that's a bit more tailored to you.
Thank you, Aisha. So again, not one size fits all, but also then learning as you go along on the platform as well. Very useful tips there. Thank you. Terence, we talked about the feels. We've talked about, you know, people being so descriptive and putting visuals and music and popular tracks together to really create robust content that captures eyeballs and imagination. Are there free apps that enables, you know, amateurs or SMEs to film and edit these short form videos prior to posting on TikTok?
Yeah, thanks, Delisha. So, you know, our suggestion is to just film and edit within the TikTok app itself, right? Because it's really simple to use and, you know, compared to the usual typical video editing apps, right? So, for example, you can film TikTok using the app. You can save this as draft, right? And you are free to arrange, rearrange and edit them later. Right? You can add on your own effects, your own music and so on. Alternatively, you can also use your own camera app to record, right, and upload these videos onto TikTok later. So this is my preferred way to do it, right? And you are also free to edit it however you want. But if you are really looking for a third-party app, I would say CapCut, right? CapCut, C-A-P-C-U-T is a good alternative.
CapCut. Right. So if you want to go beyond, you know, just the tools on your mobile phone surface, then CapCut potentially is a great third party app to get you filming, perhaps Oscar worthy TikToks, I suppose. So Terence, how do you drive content that will lead to sales, right? So we all know it's really expensive and it takes a lot of effort to produce great content. So how do we make sure that this content would lead to sales?
Yeah, so in general, we will encourage brands to be authentic and not be afraid to show their true selves. So, you know, nowadays users, they are very savvy, but they expect brands to have meaningful connections and interactions with them. So from what we see, creative, funny and entertaining content works really well, right? And, you know, once you have built that emotional connection with your audience, typically, they are more likely to consider your brand during decision-making time. So, you know, for added impact, you can also consider setting aside some budget for our full funnel ad solutions to run campaigns against specific objectives.
Okay. So, you know, again, it would be, you know, looking to make sure that you're using the right tools that can take your content further and make it discoverable as well. So we have one last question for Terence. How can businesses effectively use TikTok, I beg your pardon, to create organic content that will appeal to their target audiences while keeping up with trends and then while staying authentic to their brands and staying on brand because people are likely to skip a sponsored ad on TikTok? So again, tough challenge. You want to make sure it's sticky. You want to make sure it's exciting and relevant, and you still want to make sure that it's relevant and authentic to your brand. How do we do it all, Terence? Final tips from you?
Yeah, Delisha, yeah, that's a really huge challenge, right, for brands. We have to take care of so many things. But like I said earlier, authenticity is key, right? So this is the first thing you should be looking at, right? And to keep up with trends, you can also check out the Creative Center, right, where, you know, Aisha mentioned earlier. You can discover like trendy songs, hashtag videos and more, right? And also best practices, right, that you can follow as well. So, you know, to create effective content, basically, you need to kind of blend these all these elements, right, with like what makes sense for you. So to just give an example, if I'm working at Jurong Bird Park, right, so maybe something behind the scenes might work, like, for example, how to prepare feeding sessions, right? So So there's like a BTS, you know, behind the scenes of how people do feed the animals, right? And so on, right? So I would suggest having a test and learn framework, right? So that you can continue to improve your content.
Awesome. Thank you, Terence. So design thinking is really a big part of making sure that you're creating those ship-shaped perfect TikTok videos. Thank you. Aisha, I believe you have a summary to take us home and wrap up today's Q&A.
Yes, I do. So there are three things you can do after this session. First is experience travel-related content on TikTok for yourself, right? Get on the app. Excuse me. Check out some of the trending hashtags for travel, like the hashtags that we have mentioned right here. Secondly, check out our business website for case studies, product explainers, beginner's guide, resource hub. These are really, really useful and free for everyone to use. And it's something that, you know, we reference as well, like day in, day out. And finally, of course, leave your contact information in the survey if you would like to hear from our partnerships team on how your business can grow on TikTok. I promise we don't bite. We are a very fun bunch. And we're here to really support and get you to the goals that you have set out.
Thank you so much, Team TikTok. Thank you, Ayesha and team. Lots of great ideas, lots of great tips for getting on TikTok and also optimizing your engagements there. Thank you once again for joining us at the Singapore Tourism Board Marketing College Masterclass. And as always, your feedback is really important to us. So do scan the QR code and share your thoughts with us as well. This is Delisha Tan signing out. Thank you, everyone.